In this week's Parashat HaShavua, Parashat Bishalach, the Pasuk teaches us, among the different Psukim of different Halachot that are learned out from the Parasha, it's written in Perek Tetzayin, Pasuk Chavtet, Re'u ki Adonai natan lachem ha-Shabbat, al ken hu noten lachem bayom ha-Shishi lechem yomayim, shevu ish tachtav, al yetze ish mimkomo bayom ha-Shevi'i. It's written that a person shouldn't leave from his place on Shabbat. From here, we learn that there is an isur of tchumin. Tichum Shabbat, which means a person is not allowed to go out of his parameters on Shabbat, but the Torah doesn't elaborate what type of tchumin are permitted and what type aren't. Usually, in an urban city, tchumin is not applicable. However, it's very applicable in bungalow colonies. It's very applicable in places where there's not the houses are widely spaced from each other and it's not a real city. Then there could be a problem of tchumin that a person has to be aware of walking from one to the next. However, there's one case in tchumin that could come up, and it's not only a question regarding tchumin, but other cases as well, which is a common question for those who travel, especially they travel to the Far East, they go to places like China and Japan, or they travel from Australia to America, and they want to travel on Friday. And as one is traveling on Friday, there are situations that he will enter Shabbat for a few hours, and then the clock goes back. And if he leaves Friday morning, for example, he leaves Japan Friday morning, he could get to New York Friday afternoon. But on the way, for about three and a half hours, he will be in an airspace that it is technically Shabbat until it goes back to Friday. And the question is a person allowed to take the airplane on Shabbat if he will cross an airspace? It turns out he'll be on an airplane on Shabbat, even though he's going to land on Friday. That's a question at hand that many people have, and it has to do with tchumin. There is a sugya, there is a discussion in Masechet Eruvin, Daf Mem Gimel Amen Aleph, if there are tchumin lema'ala mi'asara, if there are tchumin above 10 tfachim or not. The Gemara leaves it as a safek, the Gemara leaves it as a question, and it doesn't resolve it. Usually, every safek de oraita is lechumra, and safek de rabbanan lekula. If it's a question on a de oraita, you have to be stringent. A question on a de rabbanan, you are lenient. However, in our particular case, tchumin, are they de oraita or are they de rabbanan? So the Rif and the Rambam explain, and this is brought down in the Shulchan Aruch, that even though tchumin of 2,000 amma are mid rabbanan, but tchumin of Yud Bet Mil, which is much more than 2,000 amma, but it's not so much in airspace, it's a couple of miles, then it's the oraita. So if one is going to go more than Yud Bet Mil, more than 12 mil on Shabbat, which is once again a couple of miles, then it's going to depend on the different opinions, but definitely once you pass a certain amount of miles, you for sure are in the space of Yud Bet Mil, so you have to be stringent, and you can't travel on Shabbat. Indeed, the Shelot Utshuvot Maim Chaim of Rabbi Yosef Misas was asked this question, whether one is allowed to take an airplane on on Shabbat. And he answers, according to what we know, that en tchumin lemala mi'asara, there's Rabbi Yosef Misas in Mayim Chaim Chelek Alef Simen Kuf Lamed Alef. If there's no tchumin above Yud Tvachim, so it should be allowed. However, the Shelot Utshuvut Lecha Shelomo from Rabbi Shlomo HaKohen, one of the great Sephardic Acharonim from the city of Dogdo in Morocco, in Siman Tet asks on this psak of Rabbi Yosef Misas. He says it could only be when you're flying above the oceans, then you're allowed to travel more than Yud Bet Mil. Because traveling above the oceans, the Rambam in Teshuvah writes, it's not a reshut Rabbim deoraita. It's on the Yam, and then there's no, it's not a reshut Rabbim deoraita. And therefore, if there's a safek, it's only a safek de Rabbanan, and we allow it. But if the airplane is going to travel on top of the ground, so it could be you're getting into a safek deoraita, it should never be permitted. So therefore, the Lecha Shlomo questions greatly whether one is allowed to take an airplane on Shabbat. Nevertheless, it could be that in our case, it for sure should be allowed, because we are going to see that there are different reasons in our case that taking an airplane should be more lenient. One case is the following. There's a question whether if Erev Shabbat the airplane is already traveling, not that you're getting into an airplane before Shabbat and it takes off on Shabbat, then you have a serious question of tchumin. But if an airplane is already in the air on Shabbat, you're moving while Shabbat is already in, while Shabbat is coming in, it could be that a person doesn't acquire the 2,000 amot. It's called naidi. He doesn't acquire the 2,000 amot while he's in airspace. There are many rishonim that follow this, the Ramban and the Rashba. And although the Biur Halakha in Siman Tav Dalit says we should be machmir on this, but it's definitely a machloket. So it could be in a case where you're not sure if you're going on top of the on top of land, and even if you're going on top of land, it could be you're going in a place that's not a metropolitan an area. It's like a midbar. It's also a question if that's considered a shuta rabim deoraita. So you'd have many reasons to say that there's no issue of tchum. Another reason that you might say it's allowed over here is based on the shita of the Bala Maor in Siman Resh Memchet, whether one is allowed to take a wagon before Shabbat, knowing that he's going to have to travel on Shabbat. Similarly, going on a boat before Shabbat, even though he knows it's going to travel on Shabbat. It's a complicated sugya, and there are many different opinions. However, the opinion of the Bala Maor that the Shulchan Aruch is posek in Siman Resh Memchet Seif Dalit is that 3 days before Shabbat, one is allowed to enter a wagon or a boat, even though he knows on Shabbat that he might come to Chilul Shabbat. And the reason is because when he's going to be coming to Chilul Shabbat, he has to do it because it's Pikuach Nefesh, and he's traveling 3 days beforehand, he's allowed. But within 3 days, it looks like he's going to be Mechalel Shabbat, so midrabanan it's asur. Nevertheless, in a case of a mitzvah, if he goes on Friday, even in case of a mitzvah, it's allowed. In our case, the Rama says in the end of Siman Resh Memchet, going to see your friend is called a dvar mitzvah. And especially if a person is traveling from Japan to America on Friday, it's considered a dvar mitzvah that he wants to see his family. That would be a reason that he'd be able to travel, because he wants to go see his family. So any case where it's a dvar mitzvah, even though he knows on Shabbat he might come to a case of chilul Shabbat, but it's a chilul Shabbat that's pikuach nefesh and there's no choice for it to happen, he's allowed to enter in a situation that's going to be a possible pikuach nefesh. Granted, the Mishnah Brura in Siman Resh Memchet says this is only permitted in a case of safek. This is only permitted in a case of safek, where one is not sure it's going to be Chilul Shabbat. In our case, it's sure he's going to be Mechalel Shabbat. Sure he's going more than Yud Bet Mil. However, the Bet Yosef implies that even if he knows, like he's talking about a case, the Bet Yosef quoting the Shirut Chuvosh Chuvot of the Tashbetz, one of the great Algerian Acharonim. He quotes the Tashbetz that says that even if he knows he's going to be traveling more than Yud Bet Mil, he's allowed to get into the Shayara before Shabbat, as long as it's a Dvar Mitzvah. Because on Shabbat, he has no choice. It's Pikuach Nefesh if they're going to leave him in the middle of the desert. And in our case, it's Pikuach Nefesh for him to jump off the plane. So since that's the case, a person is going to Dvar Mitzvah is allowed to enter in a case of Pikuach Nefesh. The Sefer Zichron Shmuel of Rav Shmuel Razovsky, as well as the Hazon Ovadia, Rav Ovadia Yosef, and Chelek Aleph, quote that the reason why this is allowed is because on Shabbat, a person is if he has to be mechalel Shabbat because of pikuach nefesh, it's called hutra Shabbat. Shabbat is totally permitted in that case of pikuach nefesh. So it's not like he's doing an avirah at all. It's not like he's doing any prohibition. So as long as he didn't willingly go into this, but he did it because of a dvar mitzvah before Shabbat, even though it happens he's going to be in a situation of pikuach nefesh, we allow it. Just like a person takes a boat before Shabbat, even though he knows he's going to be on the boat on Shabbat, and he's going to violate the isur tchumin. The chidush over here is even on a deoraita level, one would be allowed to enter in a situation that he'd have to violate Shabbat. So over here too, he's taking the airplane on Friday. He knows he might enter a situation of pikuach nefesh that he can't jump off the plane, that he's going to have to be in the plane. He would be allowed, according to this Bala Ma'or, to travel. Especially, even according to the Mishnah Berurah that says you're only allowed to travel if you have a safek pikuach nefesh. Over here, it's a safek if it's going. He's going to go over land. And there's no tchumin limala miyasara if he's going over the ocean, because we are lenient in that case. So one would be allowed. Indeed, a sefer called Ta'arich Yisrael, Siman Chaf Aleph, quotes Rav Scheinberg, quotes Rav Gustman, Zichronam Livracha, that both allowed taking an airplane from Japan to America, even though a couple hours on the ocean, he's going to be in a situation where he might be into Shabbat. What he has to do is empty out his pockets of mukzeh and not use the bathroom for those 3.5 hours, because that depends on electricity. There is a shelot u'tshuvot minchat Yitzchak in Chelek Bet, that the minchat Yitzchak questions why it should be allowed taking an airplane on Shabbat. And this minchat Yitzchak is found in Chelek Bet Siman Kufav. And in the case of the minchat Yitzchak is that somebody was traveling from England to Argentina, and he would be the whole airplane on the airplane the whole Yom Kippur. So, but he would land after Shabbat, but the whole Shabbat he would be on the airplane. He would leave before Shabbat and would get, I don't know how that's possible, but that's what he writes over there, that was the case. And he said to that person that it's Asur. And one of the reasons that he says that it's Asur is because the Chatam Sofer says that although a person doesn't do Melacha on Shabbat, but if he's going to nullify for himself the Shvitah resting on Shabbat, it's not Onik Shabbat, it's forbidden. So if a person is going to be sit buckled to his seat the whole Shabbat, the Chatam Sofer was talking about taking a train the whole Shabbat, in Chatam Sofer Chelek Vav Siman Tzad Design, it's going to be Mevatel the Onik Shabbat for him. So too, the Minchat Yitzchak says, a person on an airplane sitting the whole Shabbat is willingly nullifying the whole Onik Shabbat that he has, and therefore it's forbidden. It's very possible that the Minchat Yitzchak would agree in our case that it's permitted. Because on the contrary, in our case that he's only going to be a couple of hours in the airplane, and he's going to be home for Shabbat, he's going to have more of an Onik Shabbat. He's not going to stay in Japan, where there's not beautiful Shabbat accommodations. In America, he's going to be able to be with his children. His wife's not going to be alone. So on the for a couple of hours, being in an airplane is less of a bitul of Onik Shabbat instead of him being at home. So it's very possible that even the Minchat Yitzchak would agree, in our case, a person is allowed to take an airplane from Japan to America, or from Australia to America on Friday, even though he's going to land Friday morning, and in the air he's going to be a couple of hours. And it should be noted that even those couple of hours that he's in the air, it's a machloket whether it's Shabbat or not. There's a big machloket on the dateline issue whether that's Shabbat or not, which I'm not going to get into. That's a whole different subject. So that's another reason to say that over here it's a safek. And even though Rav Moshe Feinstein writes in Orach Chaim Chelek Gimel Siman Tzad Yivav that taking airplanes on Shabbat he's not even going to discuss because a Jew wouldn't do that, that's talking about going on an airplane because he's going before Shabbat, he's going to be in the air on Shabbat, similar to the Minchat Yitzchak's case. But in our case, it's not the same. In our case, it's only be a couple of hours in the air. It could be even Rav Moshe Feinstein would agree that it's permitted. While we're talking about the issue of airplanes, if somebody was on an airplane before Shabbat, supposed to land before Shabbat, and he landed on Shabbat, then he gets into a serious issue of Isur Tchumin. And according to the halacha, he wouldn't be able to leave. If he landed on Shabbat itself, he wouldn't be able to leave the vicinity of the airport. He wouldn't be able to leave the vicinity of the airport if the airport is outside of the city boundaries. If the airport is within the city boundaries, it could be he would have the whole city and he'd be able to walk. Obviously, he wouldn't be able to carry anything mukzeh or whatever else if the city doesn't have an eruv. But you should be aware that that could be a very big problem if he lands in an airport that's in a place that is not within a city. He can't leave the boundaries of the airport because then it's considered that he has his tchum shabbat that he landed in, and he can't violate the tchum. Chazak u baruch.